Hello everybody, welcome to the Java example section. In this section, I'm going to set up a grade point average system. So I would create a student class first, and then from this student class, I would create a student object, and I will produce a record for a certain student. In this record, I'm going to set up some ArrayList which store the subjects and the grades the student obtains. And then I will find out the GPA of this student. And the GPA is evaluated as follows. A equals 4, B equals 3, C equals 2, D equals 1, and F equals 0. And after I add up all these points, I take the arithmetic average of these points to get the GPA. Okay, let's see how I can implement this idea. I will start with my driver class, which will use the object created from the student class. So what will I do? I have this idea. I will have a student object whose reference is called Andy. And I would have a constructor to instantiate the Andy object with the name called Andy. So for this reference variable Andy, I will do something like this. Suppose Andy has grade C in mathematics. Andy has also got A in English. B in history. And D in geography. I want to create a method to obtain the name of the student, which will simply print out this string. And the GPA is obtained from the getGPA method of this student class. And after I've printed out the GPA, I also want to print out the subjects Andy has taken. Okay, this is my idea of printing out the subjects. I would also have a getSubjects method from this student class. And this getSubjects method will return an ArrayList that stores the subjects taken by Andy. So we can see how we can implement the student class on the right hand side. Because I need to create ArrayList, I need to import it first. And for a student class, I will have some instance variables. The name of the student. I will have a reference variable to an ArrayList of string references. And this reference variable is called subject. I also have an ArrayList that stores the grade taken by the student. And this ArrayList will be storing a character object references. I now create the constructor for the student class. This constructor is going to be compatible with the object declaration on the left hand side. So I will have a string called n here as the formal parameter. And then this formal parameter it will be put in the variable called name. Of course, name is a string reference variable, so we simply put the reference of this string object to the reference variable called name pertaining to the student class instance variable. Subject is ArrayList to be created right now, so I use the new keyword, and the ArrayList is storing some string references, and for me, I don't need to set up the number of default capacity for my subject ArrayList. Same for my grade reference variable that points to an ArrayList of character object references. Then I can create the getName method here. This part is pretty easy. I simply return the reference variable for my instance variable, and when I use this return name syntax, the particular object referenced by this reference variable will be shown on my printout statement. I now create the add method for my student class. By following the pattern on the left hand side, I will set up the subject first, followed by the grade in the form of a character object. We have to notice that I have two add methods. The add method printed in dark green here refers to the method that I create for this student class. And the yellow-green add methods is about the addition of something to the ArrayList. So this add refers to the ArrayList method that is imported by the java.util.arrayList command. So these two add methods are different. This one is for my current class being created, and this one is from my ArrayList method that is already created for us. Now I do the getSubjects method here. I'm going to print out the contents of the ArrayList that stores the subjects of a certain student object. This part is quite easy. I simply return the instance variable. And when I call this method, the whole ArrayList will be given out. Finally, I do the getGPA method here. Since GPA can be a decimal number, I would return it as a double value. I would create a local variable to the getGPA method by doing this approach. I'm going to store the total grade points taken by a certain student. So I would start with 0.0 and then I will add the GPA points to this total point variable. Okay, I'm going to use the for each method here. I will loop over the grades from the grade ArrayList, and I will pick up the character object one by one. And from the object picked up, I'm going to check the case to see the corresponding grade point for that particular grade. If a student has got an A in a certain subject, the total point will be added by 4. And I leave the switch conditional statement. Then I can do the rest. I can use copy and paste method. Okay, after getting the total point taken by a student, I can return the average of the grade points by using the return command. Okay, grade log size here means the number of elements being filled up by the add method pertaining to the student class. Okay, so this size method is also a method provided by the ArrayList data structure provided by Java. Okay, let us see how we can play with this setup. Let me save it. And then I run it. Let me check. I also need to save it. Okay. That's the character encoding error. Okay. Andy has got a 2.5 GPA. How can I get it? I would simply add up all the points represented by these grades. C is 3. C is 2. A is 4, B is 3, and D is 1. So altogether, I would have 10 points. And 10 divided by 4, which is the size of the grade array list, I would get 2.5 as the answer. And I can also print out the subjects pertaining to Andy's information. You see, the name Andy is also printed by using the getName method. My code is intuitive and straightforward. However, it may not be the best or the most efficient approach. If you can suggest any idea to improve my code, feel free to do so on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.